Welcome back, my dear class 12 student. Today our subject is business studies and our chapter we are already started the business environment. And our topic is very important, economic environment in India. Now, economic environment is very important for any type of business or industries. An economic environment is steadily changed day by day due to the government policy mainly. So if you go back in the history, in the time of independence, our country, most of the population living in the rural area, lives actually in rural area. At the time, 70% people, actually population, employed in farming or in agriculture. At the time, actually employment or employment related activity will always actually related with the agriculture and farming. And that time the most the technology is not good as today's life. So this is a very low productivity of agriculture production. Agriculture production was very much less at that time. So not bad. Most of the people at this time in rural area is very poor, and some just earn money for their food, not anything else they can do for that. Today, as today's technology has come new for cutting the your paddy field or these things was not there, because at that time mainly this type of industry was labor intensive industry. And the public health system was not good at all. At the time, when there is any diseases actually happen and spread it very fast and transmitted through different person, so there was not very much, our health system is not very much capable of control this type of things, and mortality rate was very high. To look at this type of things, in order to solve economic problem of our country, the government takes several steps. The main objective of India's development plans were initiate rapid economic growth. To look this type of situation, Indian government has taken several steps at that time, and the main objective, actually, rapid economic growth to raise the standard of giving, to raise the standard of living, reduce unemployment and poverty. They try to reduce the unemployment and poverty and raise the standard of living of the population. Secondly, they say become self-reliant, which concept is nowadays again come. Few days back, Modi also said self-reliant, Atmanirbhar Bharat, you have heard. Hopefully, Make in India plan, they initiated. At the time, this is few years back, after independence, the government actually want to self-rely, and they actually said, don't import any goods from other country, whatever you need, just manufacturing in here, and then sell it. This is called self-rely, and they government actually motivate most of the businessmen to self-rely and make industries which are manufacturing industries and heavy goods industries at that time. Now, reduce inequalities, income and wealth. But at that time, differences of income and wealth, income of poor and rich is very much, difference is very high. The poorer is very poor and the richer is very rich. So government wants to reduce this gap so that the economic development can be happen. So inequality in their income and wealth between poor and very rich person. In today's also there is the thing, but the gap is very low. Now, at that time, the poorer is very much poor and very few people is the richer person. So at the time adopt a social pattern, adopt a social pattern of development based on equality and prevent exploitation of man by man. Adopt a socialist pattern. Socialist pattern actually says you have to treat each and every person in equal basis. So give them more and more chances to enjoy that they are equal things in the social, they should get chance. At the time there was a very much caste system was there. Dolit, scheduled caste, scheduled type was there. So they cannot get chance, they are very poor. So this equal, they actually want to bring down this inequality and they actually uplift this type of actually socialist, actually very lower caste, actually get got the opportunity to come up and take the opportunity what government policy has said, and they take the opportunity and they actually this socialist pattern actually implemented. Now in accordance with the economic planning, the government gave a lead role, was boldly given the responsibility of developing consumer goods industry. In accordance with the economic planning, the government gave a lead role, was boldly given to the lead role actually boldly given to the public sector company for infrastructure development and private sector company for consumer goods. Infrastructure development, you know what is infrastructure, the road, the bridges, the rail lines, the electricity, these are the actually infrastructure industry. This is actually done by the public sector enterprise business, public sector enterprises, and consumer goods, who is consumed daily basis in our house, that is soap, your grocery things, these are actually, they have actually privatized. And they gave the role, lead role for that to private enterprises. In July 1991, at that time, in July, when our economic is very much depressed and before 1991, in 1990 there is very much depression in economic, we are not going through this policy is happening. At that time then the government, Narasimha Rao is the Prime Minister and Finance Minister was Manmohan Singh, is a very eminent person, very eminent economics. He actually taken a decision in 1991 in month of July. The broad feature of this policy were, I'll discuss. The government reduced the number of industries under company. The government actually reduced the number of industries for licensing in just 6. They said that only 6 companies need to take license to do the business. What are these? Are the industries? They are the liquor industries, they are the tobacco industries. This industry only actually need license, other can freely do the business. So this is actually happened in the first, in the case of 1999, in 1991 when Manmohan Singh government, Manmohan Singh as a finance minister, made an advanced industrial policy for our country. Many of the industries reserved for the public sector under earlier policy, most of the public sector company reserved for the before that, this policy, most of the actually industries are actually governed by the public sector enterprise. This is the reserve. They said that should be changed. More and more actually power should be given to private sector and the reserve the public sector companies. Disinvestment are carried out. Disinvestment means there are some of the public enterprise which was built is actually making losses and they are sick and the government should take a decision to sell this to a private sector or private company, to a private ownership. Policy towards foreign capital, that liberalization word has come at that time, liberalization, globalization, the foreign capital now liberalized. In that policy they said anybody can come and directly invest our country in 100% except some industry, that is insurance industry, defense industry,
these industries actually exceptional. Most of the cases, they actually open up the market of India to the whole world in liberalization, globalization, what we said. Sorry. And most of the actually Domino's, McDonald's, you have nowadays you are looking. This is the actual result of this 1991 policy. Hope you will understand how the economic development environment is changing day by day in India. Thank you for that.